Good evening, all of you. Good evening, all my dear students. Good evening. Welcome to An Academy. Let me start the session with my introduction. Myself, Venkat Krishna. My qualification is M.Tech Computer Science from IIT Kharagpur. I cracked gate examination with All India Rank 22. I had more than 15 years of teaching experience across the country in training the students in three different subjects: design and analysis of algorithms. That is core subject for CS students, engineering mathematics for all engineering students, discrete maths again for CSE students. Right. Before I talk about subscriptions available in An Academy, let me tell you few words about An Academy. An Academy is the best online platform in India for all competitive examinations like GATE, engineering services, IIT joint entrance examination, both mains and advanced, UPSC, civil services, etc., etc. So if you are aspirant of any competitive examination, you can safely take a subscription in An Academy, since you will get the best content in the form of best educators. Now let us see the type of subscriptions available in An Academy. This is An Academy Plus subscription. This is An Academy Iconic subscription. So basically here, this is An Academy Plus circle, Iconic circle. Suppose if it is circle A and this is B, basically these circles represent a Venn diagram representation. So I can say A is subset of B. What does it mean, sir? Every element of A is in B. Basically A is An Academy Plus circle, B is An Academy Iconic circle. Here element means a benefit of that particular subscription. It means that whatever the benefits are there in An Academy Plus, they will be extended to Iconic also. Now let us see what will be the subscription, what will be the benefits of An Academy Plus subscription. Here briefly I can discuss about live classes. Interaction will be there between learner and educator in a live class. Ultimately, it gives business to the class. So you can ask your doubts in the live chat. Who is to go through that live chat for every 2 to 3 minutes, and we will clarify all your doubts in the class itself. Once all doubts are getting clarified in the class itself, what else a student wants other than this? Ultimately, that is the requirements of a good student. So definitely that's the key success. By that way you can spend a lot of time on your subject. Test series is available, structured schedule, unlimited practice. For any student to clear competitive examination, a lot of practice is required. So therefore, we the educators of An Academy, we have started a simple activity, that is a DPP, daily practicing problems. We are sharing 5 questions in social media as well as An Academy app. Even we are sharing detailed solutions of DPP also. Such questions will contain multiple concepts. If you practice, if you have habit of practicing such type of questions, definitely you can crack GATE or ESE in a very, very first attempt. Now let me talk about Iconic. Whatever the benefits are there in Plus, they will be extended to Iconic also. Here again, in addition to these benefits of An Academy Plus, it contains more benefits. One personal coach will be appointed to you. Study planner will be there. You will get guidelines from experts of subjects. It contains questions and answers of ESE mains. Let me tell you what is the role of a personal coach. Once you take subscription in An Academy Iconic, within few hours, that may be 24 or 48 hours, one personal coach will be appointed to you. Personal coach is also a well-qualified teacher, well-qualified faculty member. So he or she will guide you in the right direction. Even they will tell you how to balance GATE classes with academics. Ultimately, if somebody is taking care of you, it's a huge advantage for you. So I am advising you very seriously, if you are preparing for GATE or ESE, better to take subscription today itself. Right. You may have multiple doubts in your mind. So what will be the duration of subscription, whether syllabus will be completed in time, what will be the fee structure, will it be comfortable to us? You may have some doubts. Let me clarify this. In An Academy Plus, 1 month subscription is available, 3 months, 6 months, 1 year, 1.5 year, 2 year subscriptions are available. So this is related to 1 year. This is related to 1.5 year. It is for 2 years. In all the boxes, you can find GVK10. What this indicates, sir, this is my referral code. In what way this helps you? If you use this referral code GVK10, while you are taking subscription, you will get 10% discount. So here, these are the fee structures. Even no cost EMI is available. In case of 2 year subscription, Iconic subscription, 1 year and 2 year subscriptions are available. Here there is no 6 month subscription. Here this is my referral code. These are various fee structures. No cost EMI is available. Remember, students, you do not have EMI option in case of 3 months and 6 months duration. Right, in this slide, I am going to explain how to install Unacademy Lending app, how to enjoy or have benefits of that app. Just you type Unacademy Lending app in your Google Play Store, install it. This is just 30 MB data. It will be installed in 2 minutes, just 2 minutes. Once it is installed, it will ask you to log in. You log in through valid number or valid email ID. You can find get subscription, click on it. You can find view plans box. That is 6 months, 1 year, 1.5 year, 2 year plans will be displayed without discount. It will ask you have a referral code. Use my referral code GVK10, apply it. Then after applying my referral code GVK10, you can find view plans options with the 10% discount. Whatever the plan you opted, then it will ask you pay the amount either in parts or full amount. So as per your convenience, you pay the amount. So immediately you get within few seconds, you become subscriber of Unacademy Plus or Iconic, depending upon the subscription you have chosen. From that moment onwards, you can start learning by choosing your favorite educator. Now here, these four boxes indicate 4+ batches have been started by best educators of Triple and ECE. So hurry up, my dear students, rank booster batches are there. Target ESE prelims for 2021 ECE as well as Triple. So these are legendary educators. You can enroll today. Use my referral code GVK10. So this is January month schedule of Unacademy Gate English. I have started on January 4th, a course, fresh course, that was foundation course on mathematics for Gate 2022. So my schedule will be 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. every day, Monday to Friday. In that, I will discuss in detail Gate syllabus as well as it helps as well as semesters. It is useful for your improving your analytical skills also. Okay, right. Now, in this lecture, we will discuss the extension of previous class. What we had discussed in the last class, we had talked about characteristic equation, that is a determinant of A minus lambda equals 0. So suppose when you deal with a n cross n matrix, so determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. This is nothing but characteristic equation of the matrix. What this lambda indicates, sir? Lambda is characteristic value, or I can also called as eigenvalue. Now this is most important concept. So when you go for a n by n matrix, how my equation looks like, it this becomes a nth degree polynomial equation. This is a nth degree polynomial. This is also called as characteristic polynomial. This is also called as characteristic polynomial. So when you solve this characteristic polynomial, since it is a degree, nth degree polynomial, you will get exactly n roots. So these n roots are nothing but eigenvalues, or these n roots are nothing but eigenvalues or characteristic values of A. Even I told you in the last class, I told you about finding eigenvalues of a general n cross n matrix. Suppose when you are dealing with a n cross n 2 by 2 matrix, let me give overview of last class just for few minutes. Then I will tell you the best shortcuts in this class also. Suppose if it is a 2 by 2 matrix, that means we are dealing with a 2 by 2 matrix. My characteristic equation will be in this form. A lambda square plus B lambda plus C equal to 0. So root will be like this. One eigenvalue will be like this. One is minus b plus b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Second eigenvalue, I use lambda 2 notation. This is minus b minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Now here, this b square minus 4ac, this is called discriminant of the given equation. This is a discriminant. I can call it as delta. Now let me tell you three important cases here. Sometimes they may ask you a question like this. A 2 by 2 matrix may be provided to you. They may ask you then which of the following is always true about this matrix. Option A, two eigenvalues are real, both are complex, something like that. So remaining two options they may give according to their choice. So here I can say like this. If delta is greater than 0, then all eigenvalues of A are real and distinct. Then all eigenvalues of A are real and distinct, because inside square root the expression cannot be negative. So whenever delta is greater than 0, then all eigenvalues will be real as well as distinct. Now let me discuss case number 2. Suppose if delta is less than 0, implies lambda 1 comma lambda 2 are complex, that is imaginary. So therefore, if the discriminant is negative, then my roots are complex roots. Now what case is missing, sir? For positiveness we have seen, for negativeness then it is in case of 0. So if delta equal to 0, so eigenvalues are real and equal. Eigenvalues are real and equal. Hope it is very, very clear. So they may go for this classification also. Now this is about 2 by 2. So even we have seen, suppose there is a n cross n matrix. Suppose when you add all elements of R1, you are getting some constant K. The same constant is obtained when you add all the elements of R2, all the elements of R3, all the elements of Rn. In that case, K is going to be one of its eigenvalues. The same strategy will work out even for columns also. Another point we have seen is, if something is an upper triangular matrix or lower triangular matrix, then its eigenvalues are nothing but principal diagonal elements. Eigenvalues are principal diagonal elements, irrespective of any size. If something is either an upper triangular matrix or a lower triangular matrix, so my eigenvalues will be principal diagonal elements. And we have seen one more point also, that is, I concentrated in the last class about two particular matrices. One is a real symmetric matrix. Sir, what do you mean by real matrix? All elements are real. Symmetric means A equal to A transpose. And even we have seen how eigenvalues of a real skew symmetric matrix look like. So in case of a real symmetric matrix, all eigenvalues should be real. If you ask me what is that eigenvalue, I need to evaluate. No option. But in case of a real skew symmetric matrix, if it has a real eigenvalue, that should be zero. If it is a complex eigenvalue, that has to be purely imaginary. So in case of real skew symmetric matrix, if they ask about eigenvalues, I can apply that shortcut. What it is? All eigenvalues of a real skew symmetric matrix are either zero or purely imaginary. If any of the option contains a non-zero real eigenvalue, you can eliminate. If any one of the option contains a complex number which is not purely imaginary, that option also can be eliminated. Okay, so you may face, when we go through previous year questions, maybe in the next sessions, you can easily understand. Now it is very, very clear. Now let us see. Sir, you have told multiple shortcuts, it's okay. Suppose if the matrix is, I am concentrating on finding eigenvalues of a general n cross n matrix. If it is a 2 by 2 matrix, I don't have any issues. If no shortcut is applicable, then still I can find characteristic equation. I can get the roots by solving quadratic equation. But if the size of a matrix is from 3 by 3 onwards, then even if you find characteristic equation, the procedure becomes complicated. So sometimes they may ask you largest eigenvalue. Sometimes they may ask you least eigenvalue, like that. So in that case, we have very, very extraordinary shortcuts. So I am going to discuss 7 important shortcuts to get the eigenvalues of general n cross n matrix. So what I am going to do in this session, I am going to give you 7 extraordinary shortcuts to find eigenvalues of a general n cross n matrix. Look at these, students. These shortcuts will be valid for any n cross n matrix. Right. Suppose if A is a n cross n matrix, having eigenvalues, say I call them lambda 1, comma lambda 2, comma lambda 3, and so on lambda n. Then shortcut number 1, addition, please students. Sum of eigenvalues, very very powerful shortcuts. Lambda 1 plus lambda 2 plus lambda 3 and so on plus lambda n is nothing but trace of A. Trace means sum of principal diagonal elements. So sum of all eigenvalues equal to trace. Now this is shortcut number 1. Now I am going to replace plus by dot. So therefore lambda 1 times lambda 2 times lambda 3 dot and so on lambda n. This is nothing but determinant of A. So sum of eigenvalues equal to trace, product of eigenvalues equal to determinant. 90% of gate questions can be handled by this shortcut or this shortcut. Sum of eigenvalues equal to trace, product of eigenvalues equal to net value. Now shortcut number 3. Suppose I want eigenvalues of A power k. Eigenvalues of A power k. Sir, what is k? K is any integer. Just you replace A by lambda 1, its eigenvalues. So lambda 1 power k, comma lambda 2 power k, comma lambda 3 power k, and so on lambda n power k, where k is any integer. Where k is any integer. So we may have some doubt. Sir, if I take k negative integers, will it work out? Definitely. Suppose if you take k value minus 2, a power minus 2. Suppose if k equal to 2, I will take a power minus 2. So a power minus 2 can be interpreted in two different ways. One is a inverse whole square, or I can say a square whole inverse. Both are again n cross n matrix. So what I did in case of point number 3 is wherever I find a, simply A is replaced by its eigenvalues lambda 1, lambda 2 and so on lambda n by writing the power k as it is. So therefore this is power k. Next I will go for multiples of A. So here it is eigenvalues of, or let me take particular case, eigenvalues of A inverse. So case of shortcut number 4 is particular case of previous, I am replacing k by minus 1. So you will get lambda power minus 1. That is one, lambda 1 power minus 1. So you will get reciprocals of eigenvalues. 1 by lambda 1, 1 by lambda 2 and so on, comma 1 by lambda n. Next I will go for eigenvalues of multiples of A. So shortcut number 5 is eigenvalues of Ka. So I can multiply any matrix A with any constant. So here k can be 3 by 4, k can be square root of 2, k can be integer. So no restriction when you are multiplying A with some constant. But when you are dealing with the powers, k should be an integer. So here k should be any integer. But in this case, in case of shortcut number 5, no restriction on k, k can be any real number. So eigenvalues of k a are, so you write k lambda 1, comma k lambda 2 and so on k lambda n, where k is any real number. Where k is any real number. Students, hope you are following. No issues at all. Points are very very clear. So eigenvalues of k into a are k lambda 1, k lambda 2 and so on k lambda n, where k is any real number. So wherever you find a, replace a by its eigenvalues by keeping constants as it is in case of multiples or in case of powers. So 3, 4, 5, they are also very very useful. Next, I want eigenvalues of a plus or minus ki. A plus or minus ki. I means identity matrix. K is any constant. So therefore what I will do is replace a by its eigenvalue. One of its eigenvalue lambda 1. If it is plus, you write plus. If it is minus, you write minus. K into, what are eigenvalues of I? One only. Because I is an upper triangular matrix or a lower triangular matrix. So all eigenvalues should be principal diagonal elements. Every principal diagonal element of identity matrix is 1. So here A is replaced by its eigenvalues. I is replaced by 1. Similarly, I can go for like this lambda 2 plus or minus k into 1, lambda 3 plus or minus k into 1, and so on, comma lambda n plus or minus k into 1. Now it is very clear. Students, I am telling you, this is shortcut number 6 is very, very, very useful. Most of the students will have some confusion here, but I will tell you, don't worry. Don't worry, students. So here, shortcut number 7. I want eigenvalues of adjoint of A. So eigenvalues of adjoint of A. Now what we did in case of 3, 4, 5, 6. Wherever A is, wherever the matrix A is found, it is replaced by lambda 1s. But here generally when you replace A by lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda n, generally we don't talk about adjoint of A 1 by 1 matrix. So how to get this? Look at this. See, here we have a formula connecting A inverse and adjoint like this. A inverse equal to 1 by det A times adjoint of A. So therefore, in this case, what will be my adjoint, sir? This becomes det A into A inverse. Now this det A is nothing but some constant. This A, this is nothing but some matrix B. So this is eigenvalues of multiples of A. So therefore, when you try to find eigenvalues of adjoint of A, make sure that A is a non-singular matrix. So because A adjoint is expressed in terms of A inverse, so det of A should not be 0. Adjoint of A equal to KB. Then I can say like this. Det A, I can write as det A. What is first eigenvalue of A inverse 1 by lambda 1? So I can say that det A by lambda 1, comma det A by lambda 2, comma determinant of A divided by lambda 3, and so on. Determinant of A by lambda n, if A inverse exists. So there is some restriction, because you may have some doubt. Sir, lambda values you wrote in the denominator. If any lambda is 0, then something by 0 is undefined. So how can you write like this? So here I mentioned A inverse exists. Whenever A inverse exists, no eigenvalue of A is 0. When a determinant of a matrix is not equal to 0, all eigenvalues should be not equal to 0. I will come to that point. Hope it is very clear. So point number 6 is very clear. Now in what way point number 6 is going to help us? Point number 6, let me discuss. Even you may have some doubt. Sir, clearly you mentioned A inverse exists. Suppose if they give a matrix which is singular, some 2 by 2 matrix or some n cross n matrix is given whose det value is 0. In that case, if they ask what will be the eigenvalues of adjoint of A, then 7th shortcut will not work out. Then you need to go through either shortcut number 1 or 2. If they do not work out, then definitely what you need to do is you should follow through characteristic equation. I am telling you very seriously, if no shortcut is applicable, then only you try to do eigenvalues or you try to find eigenvalues using characteristic equation. But when we go through solving previous year questions, it may be UGC question or HCU or GATE Engineering Services or ISRO, any question on eigenvalues, we will solve at least some 40 to 50 extraordinary questions. Definitely, you can have a lot of fun. You can understand how I apply these shortcuts. Okay. So now it is very clear. Now let us see how point number 6 is going to help us. Suppose I want eigenvalues of A equal to this 4, 1, 1, 1, 4, 1, 1, 4, 1, 1, 4. Suppose I want eigenvalues of A. So what is lambda 1? What is lambda 2? What is lambda 3? I need these 3. What is lambda 1? What is lambda 2? What is lambda 3? How to get this, sir? Now look at this. Here sum of elements of R1 is 6. Sum of elements of R2 is 6. Sum of elements of R3 is 6. So one of the eigenvalue is 6 because sum is uniform. This is 6. It is 6, it is 6. Therefore, 6 is one of the eigenvalue. So therefore, you can find its characteristic equation. Its size is 3 by 3. You can divide this by lambda minus 6 using synthetic division. The rest of the expression becomes second degree equation. You can get it. But it takes some time. Now let us try to apply shortcut number 6. So I need to convert A into this format, some matrix plus or minus K into I. So therefore, if I able to split a matrix in the form A plus or minus K I, if A is flexible to get all of its eigenvalues, my job becomes very simple, because all eigenvalues of identity matrix are one only. Are you following, my dear students? So when this shortcut number 6 will work out, look at this. If I able to represent a sum matrix which is in the form A plus or minus K I, and if A is flexible to get its eigenvalues, then my job becomes simple, because all eigenvalues of I are one only. So in the second case, I need to replace I by one only. Only thing is, you need to know what are eigenvalues of A. Now look at this. In this case, I am writing like this. Suppose, can I say like this? This is 1, 1, 1. Let me check out. This is 1, 1, 1. This is 1, 1, 1. Plus 3 into 1, 0, 0. 0, 1, 0. 0, 0, 1. So this matrix A can be expressed like this. You can represent like this. Now the first matrix is a 3 by 3 matrix where all entries are equal to 1. So this matrix can be written, like this. So I can call it as B plus 3. This is I. Now I can say with experience, all eigenvalues of B are, all eigenvalues of B are 0, 0, 3. All eigenvalues of B are 0, 0, 3. Sir, how can you say one of the eigenvalues is 3? Very simple. Add every element in the column 1. Add every element in column 2. Add every element in column 3. We'll get 3. So eigenvalues of B are 0, 0, 3. Even after completion of this discussion, I will tell you how you are getting remaining two eigenvalues are zeros with a simple trick. No need of discussing characteristic equation to get eigenvalues of B also. So eigenvalues of B are 0, 0, 3. So, but it's all of its eigenvalues are 1, 1, 1. Now A is in the form B plus 3i. Therefore, I can do like this. Therefore, eigenvalues of A are 0 plus 3 into 1, comma 0 plus 3 into 1, comma 3 plus 3 into 1. So they are 3, 3, 6. Make sure you can verify easily. You will get all eigenvalues are 3, 3, 6. Now it's, you can see easily we got, without going for characteristic equation of, this matrix A, I got all of its eigenvalues of A are 3, 3, 6. Very, very simple. This is very clear. Now let us see few shortcuts based on point number 2, shortcut number 2. Look at this. Here product of eigenvalue is equal to determinant. Here I am saying that product of eigenvalue is equal to determinant. Suppose if A is a singular matrix, if det A is 0, so product of n numbers is 0 means at least one of the eigenvalues should be 0. If det A is not equal to 0, then all eigenvalues are not equal to 0. Because when you multiply n numbers, here you are multiplying n numbers, assume that A is a non-singular matrix. It means that det A is not equal to 0. So when you multiply n numbers, if the result is not equal to 0, none of them is equal to 0. But if det A is 0, I can call it as a singular matrix. So in that case, what I can do is, I can simply say, if it is a singular matrix, product of an eigenvalue is equal to det, but if I deal with singular matrix, so 1 should be equal to 0. At least 1 has to be 0. Now let me write out two more points. Hope it is clear, students. So next note, very, very important point. If det A equal to 0, then 0 will be an eigenvalue of A. Then 0 will be an eigenvalue of A. This is point number 1. Next, let me go through point number two. If det A is not equal to zero, then all eigenvalues of A, then all eigenvalues of A are non-zero. Then all eigenvalues of A are non-zero. Det A equal to zero means matrix is singular. So if you take any singular matrix, easily you can predict that at least one of the eigenvalues should be zero, at least. So sometimes multiple zeros may come. If det A not equal to zero, then all eigenvalues of A are non-zero. Now, based on point number two, I can easily say, even let me tell you one more example. Suppose I have a matrix like this. 1, 6. Say, for example, this is 2, 12. Now, look at this. Here, det A equal to zero. So, one of the eigenvalue is zero. Now, could anybody say, what is lambda 2? Sum of eigenvalues equal to trace. So lambda 1 plus lambda 2 equal to trace of A. Lambda 1 is 0. So 0 plus lambda 2 equal to trace is 1 plus 12. It is 13. So therefore lambda 2 equal to 13. So its eigenvalues are 0, 13. Now I will tell you why one of the eigenvalue is non-zero. So in this particular case, rank of A equal to 1. Its rank is 1. Since its rank is 1, we are having one non-zero eigenvalue. Since its rank is 1, I am having only one non-zero eigenvalue. In the previous case, look at this. Suppose if you look at this matrix B, matrix with all entries equal to 1. So in this case, rank of B equal to 1. That's why it is having only one non-zero eigenvalue. That's why it is having remaining two eigenvalues are zeros. So therefore, one of the conclusion is, rank always represents number of non-zero eigenvalues. Rank always represents number of non-zero eigenvalues. Extraordinary point of today's class. This is point number shortcut 6 is very, very useful. Even this point also. Sir, can you go for higher dimensions? Yes. Suppose let us take 25 cross 25 matrix. You take any 25 cross 25 matrix. If you know that its rank is 21. So 21 eigenvalues are not equal to 0. Rest of the 4 eigenvalues are zeros. Okay. Suppose you take 30 cross 30 matrix. Assume that its rank is 19. So out of 30 eigenvalues, so 19 eigenvalues are non-zero. The rest of the remaining, 11 eigenvalues are zeros. Very, very important shortcut. So I am going to write this point once again. Very, very important note, students. If A is any n cross n matrix, having rank of A equal to K, then A will have K non-zero eigenvalues. Then A will have K non-zero eigenvalues. Hope it is clear, students. Then A will have K non-zero eigenvalues. So A is any n cross n matrix having rank equal to K. This is rank. Rank of A equal to K. Then A will have K non-zero eigenvalues. So ultimately, the rest of the N minus K eigenvalues are zeros. This is also very, very useful result. So all the shortcuts you can apply when the dimension is complicated. If the dimension is restricted to 2 by 2, you can manage in a very, very simple manner. So with these shortcuts, you can handle any question also. Now, let me tell you a few more points. Suppose I am dealing with a real matrix. Suppose I am dealing with a real matrix A. Suppose if alpha plus psi beta is one of its eigenvalue. So imaginary number. You take a real matrix. Assume that alpha plus psi beta is one of its eigenvalue. Then its complex conjugate becomes another eigenvalue of same matrix. Because what is an eigenvalue? It's a root of characteristic equation. So you take any equation with the coefficients as real entries, real numbers. In that case, if one of the root is a number in the form alpha plus I beta, then it's a complex conjugate also becomes the same, root of the same equation. So see why you are specifying for real matrices. This particular result may not be valid for matrices with the complex entries. Okay. So first of all, let me tell you this another note. If alpha plus I beta is an eigenvalue of a real matrix A. So highlight this real. This is very important, sir. Then alpha minus I beta is also an eigenvalue of alpha plus I beta is eigenvalue of same matrix A. This is note number one. Next, I will discuss note number two. Now, based on this, I can say, the number of complex roots of any real matrix is always even. So if you have alpha plus I beta, alpha minus beta, I beta will come. Suppose assume that 2 plus 3i is an eigenvalue of some real matrix A. Forget about size. If 2 plus 3i is an eigenvalue of a real matrix A, then 2 minus 3i becomes an eigenvalue of same matrix. If 1 plus I is an eigenvalue, 1 minus I becomes an eigenvalue. So multiples of 2 will come. It means that the number of complex eigenvalues of any real matrix, the number of complex eigenvalues of any real matrix is always even. So another important note, the number of complex eigenvalues of any real matrix is always even. The number of complex eigenvalues of any real matrix is always even. Hope it is clear, right? Now let me discuss one more point. How it fails, why it is not true in case of complex matrices, I will tell you an example. Wait for a few more minutes. So suppose I have a 3x3 real matrix, 3x3. So three eigenvalues are possible. In the worst case, in the maximum case, two complex eigenvalues can be possible. So the rest will be real. Suppose you deal with a 5x5 real matrix, 5x5 real matrix, size is 5x5. So if you take any 5x5 real matrix, in the maximum case, four complex eigenvalues may be possible. The rest will be real. So let me go through 7x7. I am dealing with odd size real matrices. So one eigenvalue should be real. So therefore, when you deal with a 3x3 real matrix or 5x5 or 7x7 or 9x9, etc., as we all know that the number of complex eigenvalues of any real matrix is even, since we are dealing with odd size in this case, so at least one eigenvalue should be real. So what is my conclusion, sir? If A is any real matrix of odd size, then it will have at least one real eigenvalue. So let me write out this. If A is any real matrix of odd size, then A will have at least one real eigenvalue. Hope it is clear, students. Hope these points are very, very clear. If A is any real matrix of odd size, then A will have at least one real eigenvalue. No issues at all. Now, another point, sometimes if they want to put you in confusion, they may give some characteristic polynomial. Okay. So even let us discuss this. So if alpha plus I beta is an eigenvalue of a real matrix A, then its complex conjugate becomes an eigenvalue of A. Sir, is it valid only for real matrices? Yes. So this result may not be valid in case of matrices with complex entries. So may not be valid. So I need one example. Such examples are called counterexamples. So note one may fail. So let me note one may fail in case of matrices, in case of matrices with complex entries, in case of matrices with complex entries. So I need an example. Such example is called counter example. So now I am looking for a counter example where alpha plus I beta is an eigenvalue, but alpha minus I beta is not an eigenvalue. Suppose I am taking A equal to 1 plus I, 0, 3, 2. So this is a matrix with complex entries. See, if you want to say that matrix is real, all entries should be real. If you want to say that some matrix is complex matrix, at least one element should be complex. Now here, look at this. All elements above diagonal are 0. So it is a lower triangular matrix. So my eigenvalues will be elements along the principal diagonal. One is 1 plus I, another is 2. So therefore, in this case, lambda 1 equal to 1 plus I, lambda 2 equal to, what is this, sir? 2. Now, two eigenvalues. So here, alpha plus I beta is an eigenvalue. Suppose if you feel that 1 minus I is also an eigenvalue, then 3 eigenvalues will come. But for a 2 by 2 matrix, how 3 eigenvalues will come? For a 2 by 2 matrix, 3 eigenvalues will not be possible. So that becomes 8th wonder of the world. Okay. So therefore, note number 1 will work out perfectly only in case of matrices with real entries. In case of complex matrices, the result may fail. So this is one of the counter example. 1 plus I, 0, 3, 2. It's a lower triangular matrix. So my eigenvalues becomes 1 plus I and 2. So if you apply note number 1, then y minus I becomes an eigenvalue. In that case, the number of eigenvalues count is greater than 2. That should not be happened. So now it is very, very clear, students. No issues at all. Points are very, very clear. Right. Next one. Suppose I have a 3 by 3 matrix like this. Suppose I have a 3 by 3 matrix. Suppose I have a characteristic polynomial like this, 2 lambda cube plus 3 lambda square plus 7 lambda plus 11 equal to 0. This is a 3 by 3 matrix whose characteristic equation, C stands for characteristic equation. C stands for characteristic equation. So 2 lambda cube plus 4 lambda square plus 3 lambda equal to 0. So since it is a 3 by 3 matrix, so definitely it will have at least one real eigenvalue. So one real eigenvalue is possible. So here I am talking with the 3 by 3 real matrix. So one real eigenvalue is possible, at least. One real eigenvalue must occurs. So what should be that? So in case of real numbers, positive real numbers will work out, or negative or 0. But in this case, when you replace lambda by 0, it doesn't work. But when you replace lambda by positive, here coefficient of lambda cube is 2, coefficient of lambda square 4, coefficient of lambda 3. The last constant expression is lambda. So when you replace lambda by a positive real number, you will get positive expression but not 0. So then it means that if A is any n cross n real matrix in which all coefficients of its characteristic equation are greater than 0, then such equation cannot have positive real eigenvalues. Such equation or such matrix cannot have positive real eigenvalues. Hope this point is clear. I will explain once again. Coefficient of lambda cube is 2. Coefficient of lambda square 4. Here it is 3. Here it is lambda. So all coefficients in this characteristic equation are greater than 0. But I know that one of its eigenvalues should be real, because size is odd. Even I started with a real matrix of size odd. So at least one eigenvalue should be real. In case of real, there is a classification. It may be positive, negative, 0. Anyhow, 0 will not work. But here my intention, forget about 0. My intention is to say that positive real number, positive real eigenvalue is not possible in this case. Why, sir? When you replace lambda by positive, 2 into positive whole cube is positive, plus 4 into positive square, plus 3 into positive plus lambda. How you will get 0? It cannot be nullified. So therefore, here my note is, if A is a n cross n real matrix. If A is a n cross n real matrix, of course here n is odd, and all coefficients in characteristic equation of A, and all coefficients in characteristic equation of A are greater than zero, all coefficients in characteristic equation of A are greater than zero, then A cannot have, let me write out more clearly, then A cannot have positive real eigenvalue. Hope it is clear, students. A cannot have positive real eigenvalue. So it may be zero or it may be negative. Now, no issues at all. Points are very, very clear. Now, could anybody say how eigenvalues of an orthogonal matrix look like? So forget about size. We all know that every if you take any orthogonal matrix, its det value is either +1 or -1. So any orthogonal matrix is a non-singular matrix. So ultimately, no eigenvalue of orthogonal matrix is zero. So all eigenvalues of an orthogonal matrix are non-zero. That is very clear. But in particular, but here I am in a strong position to say that if you take any eigenvalue lambda of an orthogonal matrix, that should not be zero. So if it is not equal to zero, it can be any non-zero real number. But even I should be in a strong position to say that what should be that exactly. So I can say that the modulus absolute value of any eigenvalue of an orthogonal matrix is always +1. Absolute value means modulus. Even how I will get that, I will explain you more clearly when I go through the concept of Galley-Hamilton theorem. So for the time being, I can say only one point. So in case of an orthogonal matrix, det A is +1 or -1. So therefore, all eigenvalues of an orthogonal matrix are non-zero. Hope this point is clear. Right. Now, earlier I had discussed seven shortcuts. So could anybody, let us discuss few questions on that. They may ask questions like this, general problems. Suppose they may ask like this: if A equal to 1, 2, 2, 4, then what is the trace of A^2021? They may ask question like this: A equal to 1, 2, 2, 4, then what is the trace of A^2021? So to get a trace of A^2021, first of all, let us know what are eigenvalues of A. Once, because a trace is directly connected to eigenvalues in the form sum. Sum of all eigenvalues equal to trace. So instead of, generally sometimes if you do not know that technique, people, even this is not a simple power, 2021. If it is power is 3 or 4, we can manage. But the power is 2021. So for larger powers, how to manage, sir? Very simple. Just you find the eigenvalues of A. What are eigenvalues of A, sir? 0, 5. Do you agree with me? Because its det value is 0. So since det is 0, at least one eigenvalue should be 0. But here trace is 1 plus 4. Sum of eigenvalues should be 5. So therefore the non-zero eigenvalue is 5. So eigenvalues of A are 0 and 5. Now let me calculate eigenvalues of A power 2021 just by using eigenvalues of A power K. So they become 0 power 2021 comma 5 power 2021. So in this case, trace of A power 2021 is 0 power 2021 plus 5 power 2021. So my result becomes 5 power 2021. That's it. My answer becomes 5 power 2021. Hope it is clear, students. No issues at all. So like that. So you may have some doubts. Sir, will it be valid only for powers? No, it is valid for even multiples also. It is valid even for multiples also. You can take 3 by 4 into A. You can take root 2 into A like that. Even in the future, I can go for polynomial expression in terms of A. That is by using spectral theorem. Sir, what type of questions can be asked? The major characteristic of a square matrix is a determinant. But if size becomes complicated, then very difficult to handle. In that case, eigenvalues play very, very important role. So we have multiple shortcuts to get eigenvalues. Suppose A is a 3 by 3 matrix. Assume that they give a fourth degree polynomial in the expression A. Okay. So suppose they give a fourth degree polynomial equation in the matrix A. They may ask you what is the determinant of that. So in that case, students should know what are eigenvalues of A. Every eigenvalue should be replaced by A is replaced by every eigenvalue in that polynomial equation. You will get eigenvalues. You apply apply product. You will get determinant of that complicated expression. The same thing happens in case of trace. Of course, in case of trace, you are supposed to use addition symbol. In case of determinant, you should apply product. Even we have exponential function. Even, you know, one interesting fact is trigonometric functions also can work out on matrices. Log functions will work out on trigonometric functions. Log functions will work out on matrices. Exponential function will work out. So inverses will work out. So like that, you have varieties of matrices. Hope it is clear, students. Any issues? Let me do one more question. Suppose A equal to this. So earlier we had this one. 4, 1, 1, 1, 4, 1, 1, 4, 1, 1, 4. So they may ask you. Then say, for example, previously what it is, sir? Trace. Now let us go through determinant of 3 by 5 into A square. They may ask like this. Then what is determinant of 3 by 5 into A square? This is my question. So now look at this. What are eigenvalues of A, sir? Eigenvalues of A. Earlier we got this. So how much? 4, 1, 1, 1. Look at this. Yeah, 3, 3, 6. They are 3, 3, 6. So assume that this is 3 by 5 into A square is some new matrix B. So what are eigenvalues of A square, sir? 3 square, 3 square, 6 square. So they are 9, 9, 36. Now B. Here B means this expression. 3 by 5 into A square. So what are eigenvalues of B? 3 by 5 into 9. Comma 3 by 5 into 9, comma 3 by 5 into 36. So they are 27 by 5, comma 27 by 5, comma 108 by 5. So these three, 27 by 5, 27 by 5, 108 by 5. These are eigenvalues of B, but I want delta of B. So therefore, determinant of B is nothing but product of its eigenvalues. So it is there. This is 27 by 5 dot 27 by 5 dot 108 by 5. So you will get number like this, k divided by 5 cube. Here k equal to 27 cross 27 cross 108. So I don't have a lot of patience to evaluate this. K is 27 times 27 into 108. Hope it is clear, students. The points are getting very, very clear. No issues. Like that, you can create wonders using
as to find trace or determinant, to find trace or determinant. No issues at all. Points are very, very clear. Okay. So even earlier I told about in case of orthogonal matrix, suppose A into A transpose equal to A transpose into A equal to I. So basically it means that A is an orthogonal matrix. Here A is an orthogonal matrix. So suppose if lambda is an eigenvalue of A, then I can say that its absolute value is plus 1. So the conclusion is, if lambda is an eigenvalue of A, or in simple words, theoretically, forget about lambda, the absolute value of eigenvalue of any orthogonal matrix is plus 1. But if you ask me individually, because they may be complex numbers, if there are complex numbers, then it need not be 1, it may be something else other than 1 also. So, but if it is a real matrix, if the matrix is an orthogonal, where it is having real eigenvalue, so definitely mod lambda equal to 1 means that should be either plus 1 or minus 1. That should be. It means that in case of an orthogonal matrix, if it has a real eigenvalue, fractional values will not be allowed for eigenvalues. Fractional values will not be allowed as an eigenvalues. Hope this point is clear. So here the modulus of lambda equal to 1. So if lambda is a real number, so definitely lambda should be either plus 1 or minus 1. But lambda cannot be fractional value like 2 by 3 or 1 by 6. But in case of complex numbers, it may be like this 1 by root 2 plus I by root 2. So this may be an eigenvalue. So in case of orthogonal matrix, in case of real entries, we talk about orthogonal matrix. In case of matrices with complex entries, I talk about unitary matrix. So in future class, I will talk about three complex matrices. One is Hermitian, that is equivalent to symmetric matrix, skew Hermitian, equivalent to skew symmetric, unitary, which is equivalent to orthogonal matrix. Okay, right. So almost all the theoretical part on eigenvalues is over. In the next class, we go through extraordinary questions session on this. So wait for a few more minutes, students. So this slide describes, there was a batch started by best educators of ECE for GATE 2022. The batch name is EVOLVE. So the teaching mode will be in English or in Hindi. The same equivalent batch is started by best educators of EEE on January 4th. That is EVOLVE for GATE 2022 electrical. This is official Creatrix channel, which contains more than 10,000 members. So remember, students, Creatrix channel is a part of an academy. This is a Telegram channel of our channel, an academy GATE English. So where you can get links of free YouTube classes, free an academy special classes, notes in PDF format, all notifications we are sharing in this Telegram channel. So these are India's number one study channels running by an academy. Currently, we are in this channel. They are maintaining one channel exclusive for computer science. They are maintaining one channel exclusive for GATE questions, electrical junction, an academy GATE mechanical production engineering science, an academy GATE civil chemical. Creatrix is very, very famous for electrical, electronics and instrumentations. The best quality you will get in this. Now, Creatrix is part of an academy, students. Okay. So, and one more thing is, take subscription today itself. Use my referral code GBK10. It's a great opportunity in this COVID-19 situation to meet extraordinary educators of the country. Definitely your career will be more brightest. Even your semester courses will be improved 100%. If you take subscription in an academy, definitely you will get extraordinary marks in your academics also. And moreover, you need not spend more and more number of hours on GATE. If you are currently in the second year or third year, if you take subscription today itself, so definitely your academics will be so benefited, and ultimately you will get very good rank in the first attempt of your GATE. And another thing is, one time subscription takes you and leads to unlimited access. Okay. All right. Thank you guys. Thanks a lot. I think we had a very extraordinary session today. Even in the last session also, we concentrated on characteristic equation, eigenvalues, how to get eigenvalues, multiple extraordinary shortcuts I have discussed in the class. So if you follow these shortcuts, any problem or eigenvalues you can handle in a simplest manner, students. So if you want, I will make this statement true when we go through previous year questions in the next class. Thanks a lot, students. So thank you guys. See you in the next session.